Dubai has proven to be very resilient during the course of the year, despite ongoing economic challenges, both regionally and globally, particularly key sectors such as hospitality and retail that have continued to perform well. And the outlook for 2016 is also for sustained economic growth, probably in the region of 3 to 4%.
Certainly. We're seeing an increase still in Sharia compliant capital that's looking to find a home within the region. Investors are looking for returns, certainly, and I think we asset classes such as schools, hospitals and Sharia office buildings are certainly increasing in demand. Therefore, the value of these is going up. We're working with investors and developers to try to find product that will attract this capital, money from Qatar, UAE and Saudi to find a home. And hopefully 2016 will bring with it more opportunities for this capital to be deployed.
For us, this is a very important report at the moment, particularly because there's been some criticism of the volume and quantity and quality of some of the research which is being put out in the Dubai market at the moment. And I think it's important for us to state that all the data that was demonstrated this morning comes from at least two sources. So in other words, we corroborate everything that we put out. The key findings of this report are that the market at the moment is clearly showing that there is demand for high-quality, well-located product, but there will continue probably to be some declines within the residential sector, but different sub-markets within the residential sector are clearly behaving in very different ways. For us, because we are primarily a commercial practice, the outlook is much more positive. We see strong demand from international corporates for good quality accommodation across the marketplace. And CBRE's book for 2016 is as strong as it's ever been. So we are fairly bullish about the way that the real estate market within Dubai actually performs next year. And comparatively with other markets within the GCC, we think it'll be very strong. It seems to me that there'll be two key impacts of low oil pricing, sub-$35 West Texas pricing as it is today. On the domestic market, I think it potentially improves the competitiveness of the Dubai market, because we see that other competing cities within the GCC in particular are going to be more affected by their own government's inability to spend or invest into the infrastructure or provide seed capital for new developments. Dubai, much less dependent on hydrocarbons, better at attracting new capital into this marketplace, therefore have an advantage. They already have an advantage in terms of the built environment above other centres within the GCC, and this, I think, will expand the advantage it has over other competing centres. Internationally, there's also an important factor, because the sovereign wealth funds, largely funded through hydrocarbons, are an important international player. They have a disproportionate level of investment into real estate globally. What we see at the moment is that the allocations of cash to those funds has declined sharply, and therefore there is going to be an impact. They're not going to be as fleet as foot. They're not going to deploy as much capital overseas. So we see that the sovereigns potentially will have less impact on the international market. That to some extent is countered by the number of high net worth individuals and families investing overseas at the moment. But the reduction in the deployable capital from the sovereigns is not to be underestimated.
In general, we see a big flight to affordability in Dubai. Over the past year, I would say there's definitely a big flight to areas such as Dubai Land, Sports City, Jumeirah Village Circle, where the demand is focusing on. We think it's good to see that developers are addressing the issue of affordable housing. Mainly they offer off-plan property at the moment at more affordable rates, I would say. But we think the solution would also be to look at developers and investors who are developing more leasehold properties at affordable rental rates for people to move into in the coming years.
What we've seen is certainly a fragmented marketplace where the prime locations such as Dubai Marina, Palm Jumeirah and downtown Dubai have actually seen more pronounced deflation in the range of 3% quarter on quarter. However, more affordable locations such as Jumeirah Village Circle, such as Dubai Land Residences, Dubai Sports City, all these areas have actually seen growth and decent growth as well.